Incrementing a variable is a common task that we do inside of a loop, where we want to count each time a loop executes. To use a counting variable in a loop where we want to increment by 1, we can use the following code. The variable votes is set equal to itself plus 1. Each time this code runs, the votes tally is increased by 1. Shorthand uses this format. Votes plus equals 1, which means votes equals itself plus 1. Let's run some code where we set votes equals 3, and then we want to increment it by 1, using the votes equals votes plus 1 method. And then the shorthand we are gonna increment it by 2. When the code runs, we see that the votes tally increased from 3 to 4, and then 2 more to 6. We can run the code again. Now it moved from 6 to 7 and then 2 more to 9. To decrement we use the same format. Votes equals itself, but now we decrease by 1. We subtract. The shorthand uses the votes minus equal 1. Votes equals itself minus 1. Let's print out the current value of votes and decrement by 1. We can run the code again. Decrement will decrease the value, and in this case, we can count down by 1. Here we are going to keep a count of the available seats. We start with 0, then we run a while true loop, and we count and add 1 seat each time. Seat underscore count equals itself plus 1. If the seat count is equal to or greater than 4, then we say we are out of seats. Let's run the code. Here we see the count incrementing 1, 2, 3, 4 and then breaking from the loop. Another use of a while true loop is counting with a decrement. We start with 4 seats available and then we count each time seat is filled, decrementing by 1. So seat count equals itself minus 1. When the seat count is equal to or less than 0, then we say we are out of seats and our final count is 0. Let's run the code. So we start with 4 and then we decrement until we have 0 seats available. A variable can be incremented or decremented by setting it equal to itself plus or minus 1. Now, while loops can be controlled with Boolean comparison operators so that we can stop the loop when a match is made or a number goes over a certain value. Let's review our comparison operator so we can use them in a while loop. And we have less and more operators, and we have more or equal and less or equal. Also, we've got equals and not equals. In our first example, we'll run a while loop while a value is greater than 0. We start with a greet count variable equals to 5 and it will print out that number. Then it will decrement that by 1. So it will decrease it by 1 each time it runs through the loop until it is no longer greater than 0. Let's run the code. So we see it started with 5 and prints all the way till 1. When it gets to 1, then we see that 1 minus 1 will be 0 and it's no longer greater than 0. And the loop exits to this point outside of the indentation and runs ignition. In our final example, we run a while loop checking if the seat count less than or equals to 4. Here we see that there is a print statement and an increment of the seat count value as we go through the loop, starting with the seat count to find at 0. So let's run the code.